أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وما أوتيتم من العلم إلا قليلا صدق الله العظيم. My respected brothers and my sisters, today I'm going to talk to you about one of the challenges that we are facing as a community. The situation of rise in psychological and psychiatric issues, depression, loneliness, isolation, social issues, especially in our youth. There are a couple of points that I want to give to my brothers and my sisters as a parent. The most important thing is, brothers and sisters, that we should be involved in the life of our children, number one. Number two, really we need to make sure we provide them this assurance that we as a parent are always available for them. You know, having little pressure on your child to certain extent is okay, but you have to then watch and observe the whole situation. I'm seeing cases of suicide in our young children, and that is because there is too much pressure from the parent side. We put our bar of expectations very high. We want them to be Einstein. We want them to be on the top of everything. And we should be realistic according to the potential of our child, my brothers and my sisters. Yes, putting little pressure on them to do their best, there is nothing wrong in that. But then you have to monitor and be involved in the situation fully. You cannot just close the door after giving them the challenge and task to achieve, and then you don't know what they are going through, and all of a sudden you hear some bad news. Rather, if you give them a task, if you give them a challenge, if you give them any higher goal to achieve, then you and me, we should be involved in their life to monitor, to do mentorship, to guide them, and to see what the situation is, so that you can console. If there is a problem, you can reassure them. You can hold their hands. So you are involved after giving them the task. You are monitoring the situation. Don't just go away, disappear, and then come back after a few months and situation, when you all of a sudden notice the situation is getting worse. My brothers and my sisters, so this is very important that you give the task, but then stay in contact, stay in touch, stay involved and engaged with your children to watch them, to provide them the guidance, and to monitor the situation. And always tell them that if they have any difficult time, they should always count on you, that you are always there to help them out. This reassurance is very, very important, my brothers, and we need to refresh. And I want to be very clear and loud about it, that make sure you tell your children that I love you no matter what. I do not love you because of your career, because of your degree, because you will achieve something. Yes, I will be proud of you, but you are in my heart no matter what. I am here for you. Whatever the situation is, you can always count on me. We should not get upset with our children. You know, on little things, we show our anger to them. That's why they shut this door of communication with us. So to keep this door of communication open, we should be soft and gentle with them, my brothers and my sister. That's why I always remember this hadith of Prophet ﷺ, that softness brings sweetness and harshness brings bitterness. And with my personal experience, I have seen that with our youth, our teenagers, our kids, we can deal with them with softness. If you will be strict and harsh, my way or highway, like a concrete wall, wallahi, that will not solve the problem. You will go nowhere. You are going to collide with your child, and there will only destruction will happen because of that collision. So if you want to handle your children, especially in this time and age, softness, gently, by understanding, you know, their position, sitting down with them, getting involved, and through discussion, and we all through learning from each other. If I recap what I want to say, number one, that reassure your children that you love them no matter what. Reassure them that you are here to support and help them no matter what. Reassure them they can count on you no matter what. And number two, my message is that deal with them softly, gently. Stay connected with them. Stay involved and engaged in their life. If we follow these two advices, inshallah, we will have better communication, we will have better relationship, and we will have better outcome. Jazakallahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Allah.